all those prophets of old in the Old Testament, was there any of them that they pierced their hands and they pierced their feet? Not one. Only Christ that bore the punishment and the pain, the pressure, the condemnation of our evil. And here the psalm is being written concerning Christ who will be our Savior. And it says, they pierced my hands and they pierced my feet. And so you see that this one is talking about the Savior. He's talking about the Lord. I want you to look at verse 18. And then you begin to have a feel of everything, that this is all about the cross. This is all about Christ who died on the cross of Calvary to bear our shame, our sorrow, our sin, our punishment, our condemnation, our guilt, bear everything away. Verse 18, it says, they part my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture. You remember that? That's talking about who? About Christ the Savior. This is our Savior. And the point I'm making is, why do you jump, overlook, great crash into Psalm 23? There's no great crash in the kingdom of God. You cannot just jump in and say, hey, the Lord is my shepherd. You just came in at the time when the church is standing up and the church is reading, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever and ever. And everybody said, amen. And I say, why do you say amen? Don't great crash. Come to Psalm 22 and discover Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. And have the experience that all your sins are taken away. And the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, cleanses you from all sin. It is that experience, knowing Christ as Savior, that then prepares you to come into Psalm 23. And then you're able to say, because He is my Savior, because my sins are taken away, and because the power of sin is broken in my life, because of that, now I can say, I can joyfully and faithfully come into Psalm 23 and declare that Lord is my shepherd. I'm looking at the title of Jesus as Savior, the Savior of the sinner. We're looking at John chapter 4. In John chapter 4. And we're reading from verse 41. And many more believed because of his own word, and said unto the woman, now we believe. Praise the Lord. Now we believe. Now we believe. They said, woman, you told us, but we didn't believe. We had your message, we didn't believe. We had your testimony, we didn't believe. We had your preaching, we didn't believe. But we've heard him. We've had contact with him ourselves, and now we believe, not because of thy saying, for we have heard him ourselves and know that this is indeed the Christ, the what? The Savior of the world. The Savior of the world. Have you met some people? I've met some of them that said, hey, Jesus or the Savior of the Jews. Oh, I say, it's much more than that. Are you going to tell me that Israel is the world? Are you going to tell me that your understanding of the word world is so limited that you think the world means only the Jews is the Savior of the world? The Jews and the Gentiles, the blacks and the whites, everyone created by God, this Jesus is the Savior of the world. And whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And anyone can come, and everyone can come. The moment you realize you're a sinner, and that all your struggles by yourself, all your religious activities, they are not enough to save you, and you come to the Lord Jesus Christ saying, I give up. I can't struggle anymore. I give up. I cannot lift up myself out of the well of sin all by my strength. But I'm appealing to you. I'm praying to you. I'm pleading with you. Lord, you died for me on the cross of Calvary. Here I am. I am ready to be saved. And then you are saved, because he is the Savior of the world. We're looking at 1 Timothy chapter 1. Christ the Savior. the Savior of sinners, Psalm 22. We're looking at 1 Timothy chapter 1. In 1 Timothy chapter 1, I'm reading from verse 12. And I'm thanking who? Christ Jesus, our Lord, who has enabled me, for that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry, who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and injurious, but I obtained mercy. How are we saved? By the mercy of God, not of the works that we have done, not of the money that we have paid, not of the water with which we have been washed, not of the oil that we rub on, but of his mercy, as he saved us. Salvation is by the mercy of God. And he says, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the grace of our Lord, was exceeding abundant with faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation. This saying, this truth, and this fact is worthy of all acceptation. Everybody accepting, you will accept. I said you will accept. Sometimes you wonder, why would somebody come to a conference and you know we're going to be talking about Christ, and then you hear about Christ and then you don't accept. I'm wondering, why would somebody spend all the money and then you spend all the time and you leave where you are coming from and you know there's sin in your life and you know that Jesus Christ is Savior. And now we say, you want to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ so that he'll be your Savior, and then you pull back. I'm wondering why. Why do you go to the market if you're not going to buy anything? And why do you go to the groceries if you're not going to buy anything? Why do you go to school if you're not going to learn? And why do you go to a place they're talking about Christ the Savior, and when the time comes to make up your mind and take a decision, this is worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners? And then Paul, I said, have you responded? He said, you can tell I've responded. I'm number one, the chief of sinners. And when you make yourself number one, he will receive you. I said, he'll accept you. You accept Jesus as your personal, you say, this is great. There's no bargain like this bargain. That's exactly the reason I came. And the Lord is going to take all your sins away in Jesus' name. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to do what? To do what? To save sinners. And then it says, of whom I am chief. Therefore, the Lord will be the Savior to everyone. Accept him today in Jesus' name. We're looking at Acts of the Apostles chapter 4, verse 12. Acts of the Apostles chapter 4. And I'm reading from verse 12. It says, neither is there salvation in any other. Another way of saying that is that there's no alternative. Christ has...
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your heart. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week, and the one we are going to listen to the next week, by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. If you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.